Okay, let's look at electrolyte leakage measurements by electrical conductivity meter. You can perform these under stress conditions in plants or any other cells. So we know under stress conditions, reactive oxygen species or ROS are formed. This can peroxidize the lipid membranes and damage the lipid membrane. So the electrolytes in the cytosol can leak out. So we can measure this using an electrical conductivity meter. So the normal procedure is after growing Arabidopsis seedlings for 7 days or 10 days, you can transfer onto different treatments such as sodium chloride treatments for different concentrations for 1 week to 2 weeks or 10 days. And then take 0.1 gram of these leaf or root tissues and immerse them in 20 milliliters of distilled water and keep them for 24 hours under dark conditions. Now you can read the first reading as EC1 because this is the initial cell damage only caused by sodium chloride treatment. So we keep this samples under dark because if we keep under light, it can produce more ROS and this can be an additional damage to the leaves. And now you need to boil or autoclave these samples in the same electrolyte measurements you took in the previous solution and then cool to room temperature. And now you can take the EC2 or second reading. Now, boiling or autoclaving has damaged all the cell membranes. Now, the EC2 means all the electrolytes in the cells. Finally, you can do the calculations like this. There are different calculations done by different scientists. I prefer this method. So, EC1 means the cell damage caused by your treatments or the stress. And then the second reading is the electrolyte leakage from all the cells. And make it into a percent value, and this is an example. So Arabidopsis leaves after treating with a different concentration of sodium chlorides, you can see there is an increment of electrolyte leakage. And good luck.